In 2018, Apple made a declaration about its vision for the iPad.
Hey, what you doing on your computer?
What's a computer?
That's how Apple sees the iPad, a modern device that could replace a traditional computer for most people. And with the release of iOS 13 and iPadOS, I think the iPad is finally getting closer to making Apple's vision a reality. So for this video, I wanted to figure out what it would take for the average person to completely replace their laptop with an iPad. Here's what I learned. First things first, you'll need some accessories. The two most important ones are a keyboard and a case. The case is obviously for protection, but make sure you get one that also lets you prop up your iPad. For my iPad mini, I went with the classic Apple Smart Cover because of how thin and light it is, and because of the various ways I can prop up my iPad on it. When it comes to a keyboard, I didn't want one that was stuck to my iPad. I do a lot of other things besides typing on here, so 80% of the time it would have just been in the way. So I went with this $10 Bluetooth keyboard off Amazon. It's cheap, it's plasticky, and I don't feel guilty about just tossing it in my bag and forgetting about it. And at the end of the day, it's still better than typing for extended periods of time on the touchscreen. Now, the cool thing about iPadOS is that the Files app actually acts more like a real file system. That means you can plug in peripherals like external hard drives or SD cards and drag and drop files on your iPad just like you would on a computer. But that means your peripherals need to support USB-C or you need to buy the right dongles and cables. The final thing I want to mention about accessories is a feature buried in iPadOS that will actually let you use a mouse with your iPad. You can connect a Bluetooth mouse, or again, a wired mouse given you have the right combination of dongles and cables, and you'll get this nifty little cursor that acts like your finger. Any gesture you can do with a finger and the touchscreen can be done with the mouse and this cursor. I actually found this to be more useful than I thought, but I don't think a mouse is necessary like the case and keyboard. It's still a nice option to have. When it comes to software, it's hard to recommend apps or services that will be a good fit for everyone, since we all use our devices for so many different things. So the best I can do here is speak to my experience. I am not the average computer user. As a podcast and video producer, I have a powerful desktop workstation where I do most of my work. But when I'm not at my workstation, I use my laptop for a lot of the same things that most people do. I will say the one piece of software that I think is absolutely necessary is a cloud service. I try to do as much as I can wirelessly and I save everything to the cloud. That way, any changes I make to a photo or a document on my iPad are already synced when I sit down at my desktop to keep working. So I really recommend you find a cloud service that works for you. iCloud, Dropbox, and Google Drive all play nice with the built-in Files app in iPadOS, and they each have their own robust apps. So, would I get rid of my laptop and make my iPad my day-to-day mobile computer? Yeah. I'm not saying it can do everything. I didn't edit this video on an iPad. I don't record and mix podcasts on an iPad. Could it do those things? Technically, yeah, but I'd have to jump through an annoying number of hoops. The iPad is not ready to tackle high-level professional tasks. The true power of the iPad lies in its ability to conform to whatever you need it to be. For an artist, it can become an amazing digital canvas. For a writer, it can be a great way to write on the go. For a photographer, it might be a great tool for quick touch-ups and edits in the field. And when you think about the iPad through this lens, it kind of makes you wonder, what is a computer? Hey, thanks for watching this video. Let me know in the comments below what you use your iPad for and if you think it could replace your laptop. And as always, don't forget to subscribe to Lifehacker on YouTube.